Eventually, you are with the person who's your companion, who keeps you happy, who respects your space, who is with you through thick and thin. That is what love is about. You're not dating an onion because of which you're crying every day. What I like about him, he lets me be. He doesn't want to change a single thing about me. I can be very annoying and irritating at times, but he's very cool, zen. He doesn't say things. I was in his car and he popped out the ring and he stopped in the middle of the road. And I was just looking at him. I was like, what? And he's like, will you marry me? And he just made me wear the ring. I was like, hello, at least let me say yes or no.
So hello, hi guys. Welcome to Pink Villa. Welcome to Pink Villa, Mona, first of all.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for doing this. Firstly, I want to know, kehne ko hai hum safar. You have been a part of this show for the longest. I mean, two season already. This is the third season which is coming out. How it is so complicated. I mean, that show, it is very real also in a lot of ways. But what has kept you, like, you know, what has kept you going when it comes to this show, this character? What has hooked you onto it?
It's the maturity of the character. It is about love, what Ananya feels. It is, you know, love is the strongest emotion in the show. And that is what it is running on. Because love can get dark, toxic, complicated. It can mess your life up. And that is what this show is all about.
But what is your idea of love, if I have to ask?
My idea of love is the simplicity in it. I do not like complications. I don't like messed up love lives. I'm not that kind of a person. Because eventually you are with the person who's your companion, who keeps you happy, who respects your space, who is with you through thick and thin. That is what love is about. You're not dating an onion because of which you're crying every day. So
that becomes my headline, I'm telling you, you're not.
Yeah, it is not chopping onions in the kitchen because you have to cry. You have a life to choose. You have the right to choose. If somewhere you're not happy, you have the right to walk away and not look for happiness in the place you lost it. So that is love for me.
We say that television has always been about cliché, but somehow you have always been able to pick out scripts which were very different, you know. Be it Jassi Jassi Koi Nahi or be it Kya Hua Tera Wada. I remember I used to watch that and I used to love it.
Thank you. Thank you.
How difficult was it for you to make sure that you don't fall in the same pit and repeat yourself as an actor?
This happened to me right after Jassi got over. Because I realized that I have this responsibility of an actor to not repeat myself. And also the fact that when your first debut show becomes such a big hit, you don't want to do the same thing again. You want to explore, you want to experiment. And thank God that I was in the position to choose. I was not in a position to just say yes because I have to. Just because I have to run my, you know, house and because it is my bread and butter. I had the freedom to choose and say no to certain scripts that I don't like this, I am not doing this. I was okay to wait. And which is why after Jassi, I chose to do a lot of reality shows to break the image of Jassi, for people to know me who I am and then see me in a different kind of a role and playing something that I'm not.
Right. But you know, I was reading Ronit Roy's interview wherein he said that he had his fair share of struggle wherein he had no money, you know, at some point. Did you ever face a situation, not in terms of monetary basis alone, but just emotionally a struggle when you entered the industry?
So, I've been very lucky and fortunate enough not to struggle after I entered the industry. But before entering the industry, which was before 2003, the whole of 2001 and 2002, I used to travel from Pune to Bombay because that is where I used to stay with my parents in Pune. And I used to get into this Asiad bus and take the highway, not even the express highway, it was still under construction.
Okay.
And wo bus mein nikal ke, I used to go to Mahalakshmi studio, give auditions all day and then go back to Pune. And I used to do this Monday to Friday every day.
Oh, shit. You have been in the industry for so long and with that you have also evolved as an actor and as a person, right?
Yes.
Well, was there a time aaj hum kehne ko hai hum safar mein we see a lot of intimate scenes we see a lot of bold scenes which were bold conventional tarike se bolo to bold scenes you know
I have never done kissing scenes and I will not do it so whatever you see in kehne ko hum safar you will not see me and Rohit in one frame doing all that but anything which justifies the character or the scene I will do it talking about bold I don't think I'm that kind of a person who would take the you know that leap of faith and go into that scene boldly
okay
I have never done it
so you do have a little bit of reservation
I do
okay now to each yes. their own that's always there now I have to come to this I mean you're married congratulations I mean,
yeah.
you know और मैरिज करते ही थोड़े दिनों बाद लॉकडाउन हो गया सो हाउ इज इट गोइंग फॉर यू गाइस
इट्स गोइंग ग्रेट गन्स इट्स क्वारंटाइन हनीमून फॉर अस वी वर प्लानिंग टू गो टू स्पेन एंड इटली एंड दैट इज ऑलरेडी मेस्ड अप
अभी एक साल तो वहां नहीं होने वाला आपका
अभी घर पे पिज्जा पास्ता बनाते हैं
बट टेल मी वन थिंग आई मीन जस्ट बिकॉज़ यू केप्ट एवरीथिंग सो प्राइवेट एंड I mean that's obviously your prerogative to keep it private but what is it that you saw in Shyam which really like you know made you say yes
so I have known him for the last 5 years and he has I met him through a friend at a friend's birthday party and we kind of hit it off he's a very funny man that was one big tick for me I like people with a good sense of humor What I like about him, he lets me be. He doesn't want to change a single thing about me. I can be very annoying and irritating at times, but he's very cool, zen. He doesn't say things. I like him. Yeah. I respect him. We give each other our space. We do things together. It's fun.
So did he propose you or was marriage always on cards?
No, he proposed. He proposed me in October, just before my birthday, and I was so surprised the way the whole episode of the proposal happened to be. I was in his car, and he popped out the ring, and he stopped in the middle of the road, and I was just looking at him. I was like, "What?" And he's like, "Will you marry me?" And he just made me wear the ring. I was like, "Hello, at least let me say yes or no."
Ye jannat ka scene hai. Wherein
BST bus wala who was honking right behind the car and there was auto rickshaw wala giving us galis hey hato yahan se I was saying what kind of a proposal is this
it could turn into a movie now coming
I'm
to
sure.
that but what about Lal Singh Chaddha first of all congratulations I never got an opportunity to
thank you
what is happening there any plans to resume shoot anytime soon or is it still on hold
I haven't heard anything from them as yet I'm sure they're also planning deciding what to do because most of the shoot is outdoors it's not in Bombay so it is a tough call maybe they will wait it out and step out at a time where it is safe to shoot outdoors
sure.
getting out of Bombay flying people out of Bombay so I don't know what's going to happen I shot for the entire month of Jan Feb and half of March so for me it is just 10 days more of work left so let's see when that happens
yeah how excited were you to reunite with Aamir and Kareena because you have already worked with them in 3 Idiots and that is a fab movie you know it
yeah you so what happened with me was Aamir sir called me up and I was not expecting I was like ye kiska phone hai so I answered and it was he's like hello Mona this is Aamir Khan so I was like hey hi So he's like, we are meeting tomorrow in my office, and I want to tell you, I'm very excited. I was like, sir, I am more than excited. So bonding again together after 10 years. Kareena is also doing a movie with Aamir sir after 10 years, right? After
yeah.
Three Idiots. So I remember discussing that, talking about Three Idiots and how it was back then, and now we were shooting mostly outdoors. So we were discussing food and Punjab and Aamir sir's Punjabi in the movie. I really had a blast.
So, thank you so much, Mona, for talking to us. And
thank
all the best for कहने को है हम सफर.
And
I hope कि मैं आपको और ज़्यादा देखूँ on screen.
Inshallah.
Thank you so much once again.
Thank you.